You look like you're having an absolute ball.
I absolutely loved every second of it. I think, obviously, I was really looking forward to being a part of it, and I knew the kids would be great, but I didn't think they would be that amazing. I don't know where they found them from. I was literally blown away by it. And, yeah, just watching that back, it's such good memories. I loved it.
Oh, they're incredibly talented. I mean, it is breathtaking. I've got to say that with them, I've been more impressed by the big, in-control voices than you sometimes are on the adult show.
I know, we've heard that quite a lot. I'm very allowed to say that. but, yeah, I think because they are so little, I think that's what blows you away, because those voices are so mature, well beyond their years. Like, I started out really young, and I don't remember anyone in our age group sounding that good.
Sounding like that. I think because the talent's been so high, and because they seem so calm and in control of themselves, anybody that was watching are thinking, oh God, can you put kids through this? Is this not going to be too tough for them? I mean, that was all sort of went beside the, you know, it just all disappeared, any worries.
Yeah, literally, they're so fearless. I think I can only speak from experience, because I started really young as well, around the same time as these kids. And it's so fantastic to get these experiences at that age, because it puts you in such amazing stead for if you want to take it, you know, really seriously and go into it as a career. I think I'm really lucky that I've had experiences like that and not got through to the next round and learnt that sort of rejection, because it's all part of it, and you do have to learn that young. And I think if I just started learning about it now, I would find it really tough. But because I did learn about it really young, it's just like easy for me, and I don't even think about
because it. Because, as Holly mentioned there, there has been controversy around it, saying, you know, that this rejection is cruel, or you shouldn't put them through this sort of thing.
Yeah, and I really don't agree with that. And I think, like I said, I can only really speak from experience, and having been through it myself, I feel like it really did put me in a great way for going into this career,
because it's a tough business.
It's a tough business, and you do have to learn it young. And literally, they're so fearless. They're actually an inspiration. Like, they take it so well, and I think, you know, we get to speak to them afterwards, and every kid leaves on an absolute high, and they take so much from it, and they're so young. They've got their whole careers ahead of them.
Because you work with children a lot anyway. You love doing that, because you've got your own little academy thing which you work on.
Yeah, exactly. So every Saturday I have a little academy that I run with my sister, Italia Conti in Chelmsford, and I love it. They literally, being around all that energy, they come in and they just light the whole building up, and it just reminds me of when I was young, and we did our show last weekend and they were just amazing. And
oh, really?
I love it. I think it's just because I'm so used to it and I grew up around it. Yeah, I love being around it. Yeah, and just to feed off their energy, and it's really inspiring for me. Like, I see them walk on the stage and light it up and be so amazing. It's like literally, yeah, I love seeing it. It makes me want to be better.
It must be a relief then this weekend, because they've got the semi-finals on Saturday night.
Yeah.
And that's all been pre-recorded. Can't ask you about that, because you do know what happens, because eventually that leads to you taking two of your contestants. It could be Jess, Ricardo, Sophia or Lewis. Mm. And then it's the live final on Sunday. Not your choice then. It must be quite a relief that finally it goes up to the public vote.
Yeah, that is actually quite a nice relief, because definitely, I think the hardest thing for me was making those decisions, because obviously you pick your 12 for your team because you think they're all special, but then you can't obviously bring them all the way to the end of the show. So you have to then put it down to four and then to two. And now it's up to the public, so they just have to vote for who they think's the most talented.
Are they going to cope with it being live? Do you think that will make any difference to their nerves or stress levels at all?
I hope not, because obviously, they've done, everything else has been pre-recorded, so it'll be the first time for them. But every single time, they've really risen to the challenge.
So no one's had to, in the pre-recorded segments, no one's had to stop? You haven't had to stop?
And no, we literally haven't had no stops. And, each time, I always worry, I'm like, oh, are they going to do the best that they've done in rehearsals? And each time, they just bring it up a notch when it comes to actually doing the live performance. I just know that they're going to do that on Sunday, and I literally can't wait. I just want them to do the best that they've ever done. I just want them to reach.
Well, they haven't let you down yet, that's for sure. Do you think in your category you've got a winner there?
100%. Yeah, obviously I'm biased, but I think that they're absolutely amazing.
Who's the toughest competition? Vocally. Who do you think has got the strongest group that's not yours then?
It's really tough to say, because Team Danny and Team Will are both really, really strong.
But if you had
and they're all really different.
Is there one that you wish you'd have turned around for then?
I'm really happy with Team Pixie. I think I'm going to champion them all the way. He's got to promise me that you're Team Pixie as well.
Of course.
I'm sitting on the fence, Pixie.
Oh, no!
No, I do think there is somebody in your category and I think it would be unfair for me to say, but I think there is one, definitely, there's more than one, but one of them is incredible.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, yeah.
What about you? This has been since December, I think.
I know, that's why watching the little clips back, we did that in December, it's literally, it brings all the memories back. And I think, like I said, watching it from the TV, it's different from actually being there live in the moment and like...
So you're back in the studio? Will you go... what's your plan?
Yes, yeah, I'm in the studio. I'm loving writing and making new music. And I've got my first single coming out soon, so stay tuned.
Oh, good.
And right. congratulations on getting engaged to
Thank
Oliver.
You very much.
Lovely Oliver. How is he?
He's really good.
Have you done any planning at all on this?
Not yet.
Nothing.
We haven't had a chance. It's been so busy, but hopefully we'll get round to it soon. I don't just want to like wedge it in and not really have time to think about it properly.
You want to enjoy the process of
it all.
Exactly.
Yeah.